Well, folks, it looks like the audit of the books out at Steadfast Jacksonville is going to go pretty quick, because it turns out they don't keep any records down there. So the tithes and offerings that come in, they don't keep a book. They don't have any record of who gave what, and the checks and the cash and any of that. They just don't have those records. Brother Shelley texted Adam asking him for those records. He said, oh, I don't do that. I don't do any accounting. I called up Adam to clarify, and he told me, he said, well, you know, we just count the money. We just text Romero the total, and then we just deposit it in the bank. Folks, this is insane. This is bizarre. This is ridiculous. When you're running a church, you have to keep records. You count the offering with multiple people there. You write down in a ledger the checks, the cash. You document all that. You sign your name to it, and then you make sure that the same amount that came in the offering actually makes it into the bank. Okay. Adam Fannin, apparently for the last year and a half, has just been taking the offering and just texting Romero, hey, here's how much came in, stick it in the bank. No record, no paper trail. What in the world would stop him from just shoving large amounts of cash in his pocket every week, and it doesn't even make it to the bank? Folks, this is criminal. This is insane. This is immoral. It's unethical. It's just bizarre. No business operates like this. No church operates like this. When Pastor Shelley texted him asking for the tithe and offering ledger, at first he tried to say, oh, Romero has that. Folks, that's not even humanly possible. How could Romero have that thousands of miles away? When the money comes in on a Sunday, it's counted, it's written down, it's documented, it's signed before it goes to the bank to make sure that what comes in the offering actually makes it to the bank. That's what every normal church would do. This is just crazy. And then basically Shelley tries to pin him down on it, and then he just stops texting Shelley. When I tried to pin him down on it over the phone, he just hangs up on me and says, oh, I gotta go. You know, I'm like, he says, well, we counted it. I said, well, who did you count the money with? Oh, different people. Well, who? You know, give me an example. Oh, I gotta go. I don't have time to talk about this. I got stuff to do. Bye. Folks, now it makes sense. Look, what Adam Fannin's been doing has made no sense. You know, why he wouldn't just submit to the leadership, and then this weird thing of how, you know, some other pastor's gonna have to come in and adopt him, even though there's no pastor that's ever gonna even dream of adopting him after his behavior. So what is he doing? He's stalling. He's a drowning man who's basically just scrambling to just, you know, find a way to just, I guess, just to prolong his inevitable doom. There has been financial fraud that has taken place at Steadfast Jacksonville. There's no doubt anymore, okay? The way things were run by Romero is fraudulent. We already knew that, okay? That's already been admitted. That's already being taken care of by an outside auditor, lawyer, accountant that's gonna come in and fix that. And you know, we'll see how that turns out. We'll see how that ends up. But folks, Jacksonville is being run in the same way, the same garbage financially is going on out there, and that explains Adam Fannin's bizarre behavior. And I don't know if anybody didn't see Pastor Shelley's video that he put up, just to make it crystal clear that Adam Fannin's fired, Adam Fannin is excommunicated from the church, and not only that, but all those people who made that video, we stand with Fannin, they're all thrown out of the church until further notice, because, you know, we don't know who else is involved. But Adam Fannin is involved in the dishonest financial practices, and he needs to be investigated whether he's been involved with the gambling and the hookers and everything else, because he was right there with Romero on this shady financial practice. 90% of what Romero has admitted to and what the evidence has shown has taken place in Jacksonville, Florida. This guy needs to be investigated hard.
And the same was accused unto him that he had wasted his goods. And he called him and said unto him, How is it that I hear this of thee? Give an account of thy stewardship, for thou mayest be no longer steward. Then the steward said within himself, What shall I do?